The complexity class NP is an asymmetric complexity class, which means that we treat yes instances somewhat differently from no instances. For yes instances, we have short proofs or certificates that can be efficiently checked by a verifier or certifier. But for no instances, we do not require anything like that. Consider, for example, the problem satisfiability. For satisfiability, we have certificates for yes instances, which is just a satisfying assignment. So satisfiability is an NP, and indeed we have seen that it's NP complete. But now consider a seemingly similar problem called tautology. In tautology, we are given a Boolean formula as an input, and the question is whether that formula is always true. So no matter what assignment for truth values to the variables we use, the formula is always satisfied. As a side note, it is important here that we allow arbitrary Boolean formulas, so they do not have to be in conjunctive normal form. This problem seems similar to satisfiability because if we have an input for satisfiability and we negate that formula and then could check whether that negated formula is not a tautology, that will give us exactly the same answer as asking whether the original formula is satisfiable. So for satisfiability, the answer is yes, if and only if the negated formula is not a tautology. It is easy to prove to a verifier that a formula is not a tautology. For that, we would just provide an assignment that would make the formula false. And that would prove that there is an assignment that makes the formula false, and therefore the formula cannot be a tautology. It's not always satisfied. But how would we prove that the formula is always satisfied? How could we prove a yes instance? What would be a certificate, and how could a verifier easily check that certificate? It turns out that it's not known how to do this. And because of that, tautology is not known to be contained in NP. So what complexity class does tautology belong to? It's also not known to be in P. And so right now we don't have a complexity class that captures this problem. Let's look at a different example. We've learned that Hamiltonian cycle is in NP. But what about the question whether a graph does not have an Hamiltonian cycle? So rather than saying yes when the graph has a Hamiltonian cycle and no when the graph doesn't have one, we flip this answer. So we want the answer yes if the graph does not have a Hamiltonian cycle, and we want the answer no if the graph has a Hamiltonian cycle. Let's call this no Hamiltonian cycle. We can prove easily that a graph has a Hamiltonian cycle. We just provide that cycle and then a verifier can check that it's indeed a Hamiltonian cycle of the graph. But how would you prove that a graph does not have a Hamiltonian cycle? This seems difficult. So no Hamiltonian cycle is not known to be an NP. And again, it's also not known to be in P. We cannot classify no Hamiltonian cycle within the complexity classes we've learned so far. So we need a new, different complexity class. This new complexity class is called coNP. NP contains all the decision problems for which we have succinct certificates that can be checked in polynomial time. So satisfiability, Hamiltonian cycle, composites are all languages that are examples that are in NP. We can now look at the complement of a language. So given some decision problem X, its complement is the same problem, but where the yes and no answers are reversed. So if in the original problem the answer for an input would be yes, the answer now is no. Or if we think about languages that are just a collection of words, then we would create a new set which contains all the words that are not contained in the first set. So if we have our language X, which contains the numbers 0, 1, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, and so on, for example, then our complement language might be consisting of the numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and so on. So in this example, the complement language, as you might see, is the language primes, consisting of all the prime numbers, and therefore the language X would be the set of all the numbers that are not prime. The complexity class coNP is defined as the set of all languages or decision problems whose complement is contained in NP. So for example, tautology, or no Hamiltonian cycle, or primes. We could also define coNP more directly. In that case, coNP would consist of all the decision problems for which we have succinct disqualifiers which can be checked in polynomial time. A disqualifier is just the same as a certificate. The only difference is that it applies to no instances of the problem instead of yes instances. Intuitively, it should be possible to easily convince somebody that a word is not in the language. If this is possible, then that specific decision problem is in coNP. A fundamental question is whether NP equals coNP. So, is it true that whenever yes instances have succinct certificates, we also have succinct disqualifiers for no instances? I did not take a poll on this, but I believe most computer scientists would tell you that they do not believe that NP is equal to coNP. But the truth is, so far, we don't really know for sure.